a transmission technology that offers the convenience of an automatic transmission and the fuel efficiency of a manual transmission, has made a substantial impact in the automobile world. The technology is dual clutch transmission. Since it is as smooth as an automatic transmission and offers a better fuel efficiency than the latter, dual clutch transmission has already taken a good market share. Dual clutch transmission is in fact two independent manual transmissions controlled by a computer. To understand how this arrangement offers the smoothness of an automatic transmission, let's first explore the inner workings and the drawbacks of a regular manual transmission. This is a simplified manual transmission. Here, the gears are always in mesh. You can see that the output gears are loosely connected to the shaft. Only one output gear will be connected with the shaft at a time. This means that the speed ratio will be the ratio of the connected gear. To facilitate this connection, each gear is fitted with a synchronizer cone and teeth, and the shaft is fitted with a hub. If the sleeve gets connected to the synchronizer teeth, the corresponding gear will be connected to the shaft. But the sleeve and gear will be rotating at different speeds during the transmission operation, so it is impossible to achieve a connection at this stage. We have to achieve a speed match in order to facilitate the connection. The first step toward achieving a speed match is to disconnect the power flow to the transmission. For this purpose, a set of clutch plates are used at the input side of the transmission. When these clutch plates are pressed together, the frictional force within them connects the engine input to the transmission. By disengaging the plates, we can discontinue the power flow to the transmission. When there is no power flow to the transmission, a synchronizer ring, which has a friction cone, will help to match the speed of the gear with the shaft. When the synchronizer ring is pressed against the cone of the gear, the speed match will occur. After the speed match, the sleeve can easily slide and lock the shaft and gear together. This is a simple and reliable mechanism to achieve different gear ratios. However, it has a major drawback. Each time you shift the gear, the power flow to the mechanism has to be discontinued by pressing a clutch pedal. This means that for a short period of time, the drive wheels will not get power. You can experience this sluggish acceleration while you shift the gears in a manual transmission car. One clever way to overcome this power shortage problem is to add one more manual transmission set with a separate clutch. You can see how the two sets are connected to the input via clutch packs. If you press the outer clutch pack, the power will transmit to the red set. On the other hand, if you press the inner clutch pack, the power will transmit to the green set. The odd gears are connected to the green set, and the even gear numbers are connected to the red set. Assume you are in third gear. Suppose you want to change to the fourth gear. In a DCT, the sleeve of the fourth gear is connected in advance, even when the third gear sleeve is already connected. This means that to move to the fourth gear, what you have to do is simply release the green clutch set and engage the red clutch set. This pre-selection of gears guarantees a constant power flow even during the transition phase. Thus, you will get a smooth driving experience as if you are driving an automatic transmission vehicle. Depending on the driving conditions, a transmission control module determines which gear will be pre-selected. You can see that in all these gears, the output rotates opposite the input. You can solve this problem with the help of a simple gear pair. To achieve reverse gear, a three-gear arrangement is used. Engaging the sleeve to the reverse gear will reverse the output rotation. Unlike the regular manual transmission, the reverse gear of the DCT has a synchronizer cone teeth arrangement, This means that even if your vehicle is moving forward, as long as the vehicle speed is low, you can still engage the reverse gear. This is not possible in a regular manual transmission. Before wrapping up the video, let's have a look at a standard 6-speed automatic transmission. It is clear that the DCT has fewer components and is therefore lighter and less expensive. Moreover, an automatic transmission requires a torque converter, which works via fluid coupling. So, whenever there is a speed difference between the input and output side, slippage occurs and the torque converter generates heat. This results in a low fuel efficiency. These kinds of problems do not occur in a DCT. In short, the DCT is the best of both worlds. We would like to thank our patrons for saving Ellie from death and making our video production possible. To see more frequent video releases from us, please support Ellie at patreon.com. Thank you.